South Dakota is home to more than a million acres of ponderosa pine in the Black Hills, and more than half of that's been impacted by mountain pine beetle. Mountain pine beetle has to attack a living tree, but it kills it in the process. And if nothing's done with the wood, the tree falls in 3 to 5 years.
Infested wood is also stained with a blue stain fungus. This wood is perfectly acceptable for milling. It is not a mold and does not reduce the wood strength. However, working with infested trees requires some precautions. We do not want to be spreading the insect through our logging activity. Moving infested logs to other sites can result in spreading infestation if the logs are not processed before the beetles emerge in the summer. Mountain pine beetles begin emerging from infested trees in mid-July. These dead infested trees can be identified by the pitch tubes that form where the beetles entered the previous year and the now yellow needles in the crown. Emergence can continue until almost October. You do not want to have infested logs hauled to uninfested areas during this time period. Infested trees can be felled and transported from November through June. Mountain pine beetle lives just below the bark here, so cutting as a slab is going to allow the beetle to survive. The log must be peeled to the wood before it is milled. However, the bark must be removed before May 1st. The pupae and callow adults may still survive the peeling process if done after that time period. Once the mountain pine beetles leave the dead tree, the tree will not become reinfested. Dead pines, with all their needles turning an ashen gray or fallen, can be moved and milled without any concern about mountain pine beetle. However, this older wood is often infested with Sawyer beetles and degrades too much to be used for wood products.
South Dakota has a lot of infested pine wood, but we can turn that into useful products if we're careful.